back to my class. This is Mehjabeen Fatima, a teacher at Elizabeth High School and Junior College. In our previous session, we have completed 15th chapter, and today in this session, we are going to start 16th chapter, that is making of laws in a state assembly. Now, let's begin with our chapter. So far, we have been reading about how people manage their public affairs, how they ruled or were ruled. We studied about tribal society, which were small and which managed all their public affairs through consultation in meeting and had a headman who carried out the decisions. In kingdoms and empires, we saw how these matters were decided by kings and their officials, how kings fought with each other to gain control over more people and lands. We also saw how chiefs and warriors controlled the lives of people and levied taxes on them at their will. They used the money to build large palaces for themselves, to fight wars, and also to build some public utilities like tanks, canals, and temples or mosques. We also saw how the British established their powers so as to exploit the resources of our country and how this was resisted by our people. So, in the previous chapters, we have seen the different concepts relating to different things. Like, we have read about how people have managed the public affairs and how they have ruled and how they were ruled. And we have also studied about the tribal societies of the small people, how they will be having the consultation meetings and how the headman will decide to carry out the decisions related to his tribal society. And in kingdoms and empires, we also saw that how these kings were ruling the country or were ruling the different kingdoms and how they got defeated by each other and how they fought with each other and how they have expanded their kingdom. And at last, we also saw that how these Britishers, they have established their power to our country and how they tried to exploit the resources of our country and how our country people have resisted through this problem. So, today we do not have any king or warriors ruling us. We became independent of the British rule more than 70 years ago. So, how do we rule ourselves now? We know that there are MPs, MLAs, ministers, chief ministers and high officials. Are they like the kings of olden times? Can they do what they please? No, modern government are run according to laws. No one is above the law and all ministers and officials have to function according to laws. Who makes the law? How the laws are made? Are they made as per the whims of the rulers? No, the laws are made by legislative assemblies and the parliament. So, today we already know that we are free from kings and warriors and we are independent of the British rule more than 70 years ago. So, how do we rule ourselves now? Maybe you know about MPs, MLAs, ministers, officials. Are they the kings of our times? Can we say that these are the kings of our times and can they do whatever they want? No. So, they cannot do. There are some rules and regulations which are made and they must follow those rules and regulations. Now, there is a question that who makes those laws? Who is the person who is responsible for making the laws? Are they themselves making the laws and implementing it? No. So, the answer for this is no, because these laws, they are made by the legislative assemblies and the parliament. So, Indian constitution is providing us a legislature for each state. Legislature is having its own governor and one or two houses. The legislatures in the state are either bicameral or unicameral. The lower house is always known as the legislative assembly and the upper house wherever it exists as the legislative council. At present, very few states have bicameral legislature. So, these legislatures, they are again of two kinds, that is bicameral or unicameral. And the lower house, it's always called as the legislative assembly, whereas the upper house, it's called as the legislative council. Let's see about the legislative assembly. This is the most important body for making laws in a state. State governments are responsible for implementing these laws and formulating policies for the welfare of the state. It's largely composed of members of the assembly. State assembly members are elected by the people just as panchayat members are elected. The normal tenure of the legislative assembly of every state is for 5 years, but it may be dissolved earlier by the governor. Likewise, its terms can be extended by 1 year at a time by the parliament during a national emergency. The state legislature must meet at least twice a year, and the interval between any two sessions should not be more than 6 months. So this is the important body for making the laws in the state, and state government, they are responsible for implementing these laws and formulating policies for the welfare of the particular state. And this state assembly members, they are elected by the people, just like the panchayat will elect its leader. So same like that, these state assembly members will also get elected by the people. And the normal tenure of the state assembly of every state, it's for 5 years, but it can be dissolved earlier by the government. And same, its terms can be extended by 1 year at a time by the parliament during a national emergency. So this state legislature, it must meet at least twice a year, and the interval between the two sessions should be more than 6 months. Assembly constituency. Each member of assembly is elected from a constituency. The number of constituencies in a state will depend upon its population. Telangana state has 119 constituencies. A constituency in Telangana has about 170,000 voters. You may remember that all men and women of 18 years of age or above have the right to vote. They have to get their names registered as voters in the area where they live. All voters of one constituency will vote to elect one member of the assembly. So each member of this assembly is elected by a constituency, and the number of the constituency will be dependent upon the population of that particular state. And in our state, that is Telangana, we are having 119 constituency, and a constituency in Telangana is having 170,000 voters. So only the persons who are above 18 can vote. So they have to register their names as voters in the area where they are living, and then they can choose any one member for the assembly. In elections, political parties play a major role. All political parties and candidates come out with election manifestos. These manifestos are descriptions of programs that they intend to undertake and promises that are relevant to the local context. And their supporters conduct campaigns by holding meetings and visiting the voters door to door. So in elections, we can see that these political parties, they are playing a major role. All political parties and candidates, they will come out in election manifestos, as these manifestos are the descriptions of programs that are intent to undertake and promises that are relevant to the local context. These political parties, they will come out and they will aware the people about the promises which are done by them, and they would ask the voters to vote for them. And the candidates and their supporters, they conduct campaigns and hold meetings, and they will also visit the voters door to door. Let's see about the election of MLA. Election commission can conduct the election of all state assemblies. Usually election to the state legislative assembly are held once in every 5 years. Persons aspiring to become MLAs contest these elections. Various political parties field their candidates. There are also individuals who contest the elections but do not belong to any political party. They are known as independents. To contest elections, a person must be a citizen of India and should have completed 25 years of age. So this election commission can conduct the election of all the state assemblies. Usually the election of the state assembly, so this state legislative assembly are held once in every 5 years, and the persons who are aspiring to become MLAs can contest these elections. And there are also some individuals who can contest these elections, but they do not belong to any other political party. So these candidates, they are called as independents. And to contest election, a person must be the citizen of India, and he or she should have completed the age of 25 years. And he or she should not hold any office of profit under the state or central government, and should possess such other qualifications as may be prescribed by the law. In elections, political parties play a major role. On the election day, people vote one by one. The officer in the booth is responsible for taking the identity of the voters. In most cases, the election commission has given voter identity. These cards have to be shown to the officer. The voter do not reveal whom they voted for. It is a secret ballot. Election commission uses ballot boxes or electric voting machines in election process for casting votes. So on the day of election, the people can vote one by one, and the officer will be there at the booth, and he will be responsible for checking the identity of that voter. and in most cases, election commission will give the voter identity card to the voter so that this card can be shown at the time of the election and they can cast their vote. The voter should not reveal to whom they have voted for, as it is a secret ballot. An election commission, he used these ballot boxes or electronic machines in process for casting a vote. And after voting, all voters are counted on a scheduled date, and candidate who secures the highest number of the votes is declared as elected. Let's see about the state assembly. All the MLAs together elect a person as a speaker. The speaker conducts the assembly meeting. He or she decides what should be discussed, when and who will speak, and in what order. If anyone disobeys, speaker has the power to punish them. So all the MLAs, they together elect a person as their speaker, and the speaker will conduct the assembly meetings, and he or she can decide what should be discussed in the meeting, when and who will speak in the meeting, and in what order they should speak. And if anyone will disobey this speaker, then this speaker, he or she is having the power to punish them. As mentioned above, the assembly has to approve all the laws, policies and levying of taxes by the government. Before giving approval, the members discuss the proposals very carefully and different points of views are expressed. So as we have seen, this assembly, it has to approve all the laws, policies and levying taxes by the government. It has to approve all the laws, policies and levying of taxes by the government. And before giving the approval, the members, they must discuss the proposals very carefully, and they should also discuss the different points and views related to that policy. And these are also reported through the help of newspapers and TV to the public. The MLAs also keep track of all the developments in their constituencies and place the problems of the people before the assembly. The minister of the concerned department has to take inquiries and find suitable solution. The ministers and the cabinet, including the chief minister, are answerable to the assembly. That is, they have to answer any question raised by a member with regard to their work. If the answer is not satisfactory, the members may force the concerned minister to resign. These MLAs, they also keep the track of the development of their constituency and the problems which are faced by the people before the assembly. And the minister of that concerned department, it has to make the inquiries to find the suitable solution for that problem. And the ministers of the cabinet, which includes chief minister also, they are answerable to the assembly, and they have to answer any question which is raised by the member with regard to their work. And if the answer is not satisfactory, then the members, they can force the concerned minister to resign. Let's see about the making of laws. How do the assemblies make laws? Usually, laws are drafted by the ruling party, as it alone has the majority support in the assembly to pass them. However, on some issues, a member can also propose a law and it can be adopted if the majority supports it. So, how do the assemblies make laws? So, usually these laws, they are drafted by the ruling party, as it is alone the majority support in the assembly to pass them. And on some issues, a member can also propose a law and it can also be adopted if the majority will support that law. Let us have a look at the procedure of making law. Before a law is passed, the proposed law is called a bill. After being passed by both the chambers and after the approval of the governor, it becomes a law and is called an act of the state legislature. So, before the law is passed, the proposed law is called a bill, and after being passed by both chambers and after the approval of the governor, it will become the law and it is called as act. The ministers who bring the bill will describe in detail the reason for the new law in the assembly. There will be a lot of discussion and sometimes oppositions from different MLAs. There could be suggestions to improve the provisions in the bill. A small committee consisting of both ruling parties and opposition members is set up to discuss these suggestions. After taking all such aspects and necessary changes into account, it will be first approved by the cabinet, then it will be placed before the assembly for voting. If more than half the members of the Vidhan Sabha accept the bill, it will be passed and taken to the Vidhan Parishad. So, the members, they will bring the bill and describe about the bill in details and the reasons for making the new law in the assembly. And there will be a lot of discussion, and sometimes these oppositions from the different MLAs, and sometimes there will be a lot of discussions as there will be opponent parties in that meeting. And after taking all such necessary aspects and after hearing to the thoughts of each party, the first bill will be approved by the cabinet and then it will be placed before the assembly for voting. If more than the half of the members of Vidhan Sabha accept the bill, then it will be passed and taken to the Vidhan Parishad. If the Vidhan Parishad passes it, then it will be sent to the governor for approval. So if the Vidhan Sabha committee, if they are accepting this bill, then it will be forwarded to the governor for approval. After his or her approval, the bill will be called an act and published in gazette. So if the governor also approves the bill, then it will be called as act and it can be published in gazette. So this was all about our 16th chapter, that is making of laws in a state assembly. So here we are done with our chapter and we will continue our next chapter in next class. Thank you.